Welcome, welcome. This is going to be a new series on an old game. This could turn into the classic go-to game on the channel. We had a Carlisle United series. Enough said about that. This time I'm going to play as somebody that I follow, and I want to do everything I possibly can to have a successful game with this team because I follow them. I mean, if we just look down that squad, anybody remember any of these players? There's probably two or three in there you think, yeah, definitely remember this guy, even if you're not a Derby fan. Him. I mean, he was one of the best keepers I've ever seen in a Derby show, there's no doubt about that. Although Scott Carson currently is giving him a run for his money, he's been unbelievable. Anyway, the other one will be him. I mean, he was an absolute really, really good player. He was a Derby for a long time, as you can see here. But he came from the Giants AC Milan before that. So very, very good. And then finally, another one that's probably on the list of people that people would know would be Ravanelli. Aging in this game, not as good as he used to be. They've got a couple of players in there as well that you'd look at. There's this one guy in particular that you have to look out for. He turns out to be an absolute superstar in the game if used right. So it's going to be interesting. So that's what we're going to go for. A shout out to all you Derby fans out there. The wobble's real. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah. This is playing through an external disk drive. I had a lot of problems with the game a few months back. Got it downloaded, then I had a corruption problem and all sorts of things. But there we are. It was always going to be a difficult season. What we're starting with, Fulham, Bolton and Charlton. Okay. So you can argue that they're all winnable games. So let's have a look through this first team and assess where the weak points are. I just want to check reserves if anyone jumps out at me that I could do with having them. Actually, no, I'll come back to it. So let's start with the keepers. Poom, we've already looked at. He's a very good goalkeeper. You're going to struggle to get better than that in relation to this. So yes, there are better keepers in the game and better in the Premier League, but for now he's going to be very, very useful. Andy Oakes, not so great, but he's an ample deputy if we need one. It's, you know, I could do with probably one more keeper that's decent, because if we have a look in the reserves, we've only got the kids, really. Lee Camp, still playing today, actually, Lee Camp. Decent for his age, 16 years old, 11 reflexes, and handling not very good at 4 though. Agility even worse at 2. A lot of work needing there. Lee Grant, a little bit older, 2 years older in fact. Better handling of 12. Not so great at the reflexes. I think he's one less, but he's got better agility and anticipation, so he could potentially be the one. I'm going to send him out on loan if I can, and see if we can get a loan offer for him, because he could be very, very good. Now, there's a couple of players in this reserves that are asking for their future to be clarified. That's what the foot means here. If we click on that, wants clarification on their future. So let's go through them. Con Blatsis is a centre-back. Bear in mind, all these stats are out of 20, guys. So that gives you an indication of what to look for. Now, in a defender, what I want, rightly or wrongly, could be proven either way in this game, is someone that can have at least, ideally, 15 marking, heading, and tackling. Having strength like this guy has is an added bonus, and if you've got a decent pace, oh, where's his pace? It's 5, so he's horrendously slow. That is going to be excellent. He's got good balance, but he's just really, really not good enough for this level. He is one of those players that I will be letting go on the transfer list. He's not needed. $950k hopefully will be coming in for him. Hope you agree. If not, let me know why you think not. Yes, he's an Australian international, but I don't know. Next one is Bjorn Otto Bragstad. What a name. He is another player that I'm not massively keen on. He's got a very, very good heading of 20, best you can get in the game. But look at everything else. It's 11 marking, 11 pace, 14 tackling. He's okay. He's better than the other guy, in my opinion, but still another one that is not good enough to be at my club. So he is going as well. So those two have had their future clarified. And they're both wanted. That's excellent. Next two that won their future clarifying, are Lee Morris. He's got good pace. Just give me 1 second. Sorry, just had to do something there. He's got semi-decent potential, but I don't necessarily think he's good enough. He's not very good finishing for a forward. He's quick, decent technique, decent being up towards average, really good work rate. But again, sorry Lee, but this time I'm going to get rid of you. I usually keep him, but I'm going to get rid of him, send him out. The last one is Dion Berta. He can turn into a decent player for me. I've seen that in the past. He's okay, but needs a lot of work. So for now, I will promote him to the seniors, and we'll have to see how things go. Marvin Robinson is another one, 21 years old. He's got potential, so he's one that I would like to keep if we can. But I'm going to send him out on loan if possible. So that's all the sort of players that want clarification on their future. There's nobody else really in this reserve that I'm really massively, into. He's okay. He's 18 years old. He's another one that I'll send out on loan. He's worth £500,000. If we can get him a season or two on loan of experience, he might be worth a couple of million in the future. Now back to him, Makoku. Already you can see he's got some high numbers there. Determination, dribbling, finishing, pace. Finishing, sorry, is low, but it can be high. Off the ball and pace, 16 and 15 respectively. And he's got a good technique about him. He's got to work on his strength. He's a weakling. As he has, his heading and things as well. But I'm going to send him out on loan. He's another one. And I'm going to up his status to hot prospect as well. His contract at the moment ends this year, so I'm going to offer him a new deal. 625 quid a week, take it down to 600. But I'll give you a signing on fee of 3 grand. How about that? Okay. Hopefully he'll want to stay. So there we go, those two guys are going, and we know this, and Morris is going as well. Branko Strupar, he's a decent striker. He arguably is the best striker at the club at the current time. He's got good heading ability, relatively influential as well. He's got good flair. He's quite aggressive, so we must watch out for that. Quite brave, and above average finishing, I would say. I'd say average finishing is 12. Anything above that is about 15 is above average, and 15 and higher is good for me. That's my opinion. And he's very, very good at set pieces. He's got stamina and strength. So he's my go-to striker, I think, at the moment. He's out for about a month, so that's something unfortunate. He's not going to be ready for the start of the season. But we'll get there. We'll have to see. He's definitely going to stay with us. All the strikers at the club at the moment, he's classed as a striker. But I like to play him as an attacking midfielder. He can be lethal in the right position. I mean, he's got 20 technique, great dribbling ability, flair. He's just a skillful flair player. Somebody you'd like to see going forward. One second, just got to check something. Sorry about that. Next striker that's classed as a striker on the team is Malcolm Christie. He's excellent. Realistically, for his age, he's got pace, he's got dribbling ability, finishing ability. He's definitely got the ability to turn the screw if needed. I'm thinking at the moment him and Stroop are probably the go-to guys, with Ravanelli as a backup. I don't know, Ravanelli really isn't very good, but this is his debut season, I've got to give him a chance. So, strikers, I could get rid of Burton, I'm still debating that. But I seem to be okay. That moves on to the midfield area. Now that's an area that I want to improve on. We're okay in the attacking midfield area. Craig Burley, highly influential player, good all-rounder really, average stats, not anything standout, but you know he's not going to let you down, you know that. And you can sometimes get big money for him if the right club comes in. Another attacking midfielder, Daryl Powell. Who remembers this guy, Derby fans? Hey? I know I can. He's very, very quick. He's got good work rate and stamina, but he's definitely the backup. But he can play on the left as well, which is useful. Centre midfielders, we're okay as well. Very abundance of players in that. We've got Adam Murray, young lad, 19 years of age. I think at the moment he's probably going to be a fringe player, so might as well load him out, trying to get him some game time. I've got another young lad, Seth Johnson. He's very, very good. He can develop into a superstar as well, in my opinion. He's very, very good, quick, determined. He's got the aggression there, but you need that as a defensive midfielder, in my opinion. He needs to throw some tackles in there. He's got good heading ability. He's fit. He's a fit lad, and he works exceptionally hard. So he's somebody you want in your team, really. Stefano Ragno, I have a lot of time for him. I used to love watching him play. Absolutely adored it. That passing stat isn't right. I think he should be higher than that. But as you can see, another player that works exceptionally hard. Decent technique, even though he's at 34 years of age now. He's not a bad midfielder. He's still got some decent stats. He's brave, agility's still up there, he's decent. And Simo Valakari as well, he's an international on this game. He's okay, he's not bad, he's got good tackling ability. He's another guy that's got good stamina, he's a fit lad. Doesn't work as hard as the other two, but I might play a three in the midfield, so he could be the third one to fit in if I play that system. He's got a slightly lower aggression as well, so he's an option definitely. He's the best dribbler of the three so far, the fourth so far that we've looked at. But as you can see, there's only one player that can play at the right, two players that can play at the left. So that's something that we need to address, and I will be addressing that shortly. That leads us on to our defensive players. Got two left backs. Danny Higginbottom is quick, got decent technique, and he works hard. Other than that, not sure he's my kind of guy, to be honest. Paul Bortien, even worse. He is terrible. He's got good heading. In fact, the more I look at him, he's just going to go. I can't stand him. But there's plenty of left backs to choose from on this game. I'm going to get one in. You'll see who I have. Right back, we have two options. Daniele Dino, I think that's pronounced. Decent player. He'll probably stay in as my backup, to be honest. And then you've got Yuldarini, or Yul, will be easier to say, Mwini. Not a bad player. He's okay for a young lad. He is in terms of football. He's 21. Not quite as young as some of them out there, but he's young, and, you know. Has some potential ability in there. Centre back options, we have three of them at the club currently that are good. This one in particular, Brian O'Neill, he seems to be my go-to centre back, but maybe this game will change it up a bit. But yeah, he's got some good stats in the right areas for me. 17 heading ability, 16 marking ability, 16 tackling ability. So, you know, for me, good stats in the right areas. He's a determined player. He's got okay positioning, that could be better. Anticipation is okay as well, so he's not a bad defender in my opinion. And you've got Chris Riggott. His stats do vary depending on what port of the game you get. It's a bit weird. But he's, again, a very, very good player. He's young, he's 20 years old. For his age, I think he is very good. He's got good, where was it? I just saw his positioning, 17 there. Which I like. Tackling 14, heading 14, and marking of 8. So he needs a bit of work, but we will work on him. Hopefully we can turn him into a good player. Next one is Stevie Elliott. I can't see him being much more than a backup player. For me, he just doesn't fit it in very well. He's determined, yes. He's got okay heading, average marking and average tackling, so he's not the greatest. And then finally you've got Horacio Carbonari, so he's another good all-rounder. You know, I think he's probably going to be, at the moment, unless we can get a new centre back, will probably be the guy that I go to on top, as well as O'Neill. So that's going to be the two centre backs for now. But the plan is, looking at that team, I think you'll all agree that we need to improve it defensively. You know, looking at that, we have got 9.2 million to spend. There's not a bad amount of money. So that's just a brief sort of overview of things. I am going to go through over the next few videos. Ah, lovely, get some transfer bids in, that's good. You know, go through some transfers, all being well, and training and things like that. And we'll also take a look at the backroom stuff and sort of see where we are. So I'm going to leave it at that for this first video. I think that's a good starting point. Hopefully that'll whet your appetite to see how we get on. I'm looking forward to this. I can't wait. It's going to be absolutely great. I hope you guys will come along for the ride with me, and we'll see if we can turn my club into a force in Europe again, like they used to be in the 70s. I'd love to be able to do that, but it's going to take some time and a lot of patience. So let's see how we do. Until the next video, thank you for watching and take good care. Bye-bye.